Zaharan Kasim was hailing from a poor background. He has completed only up to grade 5. He was enrolled as a student at the Jamiatul Falah Arabic College, Kathanguri. But owing to his bad character, he was expelled by the Board of Administration in 2005. Honorable members, gradually he started his incendiary speech from 2006. Following that, he also propagated Muslim students should not stand up or respect the national anthem. So there was also controversy. Zaharan went to Japan. He returned and started his activities at the same organization. But there was a dispute arose between him and the organization, and he was expelled from the Darula. After that only he started a national Tawheed Jamaat. In 2017, March 10, Zaharan started a campaign against the different ideological people. Zaharan's followers used knife, clubs, swords. Zaharan was not arrested.
Kathankudi, you have certain roads that have Arabic wording.
Without learning Arabic, Quran cannot be...
In Sri Lanka has two official languages.
Yes, yes.
So when you have two official languages, a link language,
it does need to. Why should be? Why should be? You learn Arabic to understand Quran and other prophetic traditions. You should not display on the road and make it Arabized.
Yeah,
I have seen the main road which is decorated, embellished with palm trees.
Yeah.
And there is a board and I don't
know. You said about Arabization of Kathankudi. It has been going on for some time.
Yeah.
How did it happen? Who started it?
Honorable member, the parliamentary representative Kathankudi, Mr. Such and Such.
Who?
Hizbullah. And it has taken place during his time. They planted the palm trees.
Would you say that Mr. Hizbullah was the prime mover?
I don't know whether he's a prime mover. Because he has been in politics for about 25 years or 30 years. This has taken place during his 10 years.
මේ අතර පස්කුවිරිදා ප්‍රහාරය පිළිබඳ සොයා බැලීමට පත් කළ විශේෂ තේරීම්කාරක සභාව හෙට දිනේදීත් සාක්ෂි සටහන් කර ගැනීමට නියමිතයි. නැගෙනහිර පළාත් හිටපු ආණ්ඩුකාර MLA හිස්බුල්ලා, රාජ්‍ය පරිපාලන අමාත්‍යාංශයේ ලේකම්වරයා සහ හිටපු පොලිස්පති NK ලංගකෝන් යන අය ඊට කැඳවා තිබෙනවා.
මගේ විශ්වාසය මැක්සිස්.